Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. And I hope you can put the peace in the Lord's life be all that's with you. In the waters of baptism, and in the name of Christ, the Lord, in your life, we can now share with him eternal joy.
In life, Paddy cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life: "Come, blessed of my Father." And in baptism, he received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. We also share some other symbols of Paddy's life. The football, representing Paddy's love for the GAA, his involvement with Drumcondra Football Club, his love for Meath in the good days, I suppose, like us all, we hope for better days, and his interest in Sidon Football Club when his own sons were playing. And the hedge clippers. Paddy was always cutting his hedge and kept the flowers blooming. I would never have a leaf out of place. And the newspaper represents Paddy's time working in Callan's shop from Conrad. He'd always bring his paper home to read, and later started his day by going to get his daily paper. So as we gather in sadness today, it was the sadness as we gathered around Paddy's coffin there a few moments ago. We here in the church and outside and all around extend our sympathy to Teresa, Paddy's wife, sons Patrick, David, Dermot, daughter Caroline, brother Terry, sisters Kathleen, Bridget, Nan, Mary and Teresa, his grandchildren, in-laws, nieces, nephews, relatives, neighbours and friends. Gracious God, we entrust Paddy into your everlasting care. We thank you again for all he means to us, for the person he has been, the service he has offered to his community, the contribution he made to many lives. We thank you for everything he means to his family, his colleagues and friends, and to us today. We thank you for his achievements, which we can all look back on with pride, the challenges he faced, the obstacles overcome, successes won, potential fulfilled together. We thank you for the experiences we've been through together, particularly maybe in recent times, but all through his life, the love and the friendship we have shared, the qualities and characteristics that make Paddy special to us. We thank you for Paddy's faith, his commitment to Christ and community, faithful discipleship and personal experience of your love. We thank you for all that we owe to Paddy, for the many ways he enriched our lives, the memories we will always have as a tribute and legacy. We come in hope today, Lord, trusting in your promise and assured of your gracious purpose, that in the faith that we entrust Paddy and ourselves into your gracious keeping, now and for all eternity. As we come together with our love as family, friends, neighbours, community, we begin conscious we do not love as well as we might have, and ask the Lord for pardon and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. Eternal God, you made the union of man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and his church. Grant peace and mercy to Paddy, who is united in love with Teresa. May the care and devotion of his life on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Teresa and his family as they now turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith, lighten their loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord. So now we have our first and second reading.
First reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven. A time for giving birth, a time for dying. A time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted. A time for killing, a time for healing. A time for knocking down, a time for building. A time for tears, a time for laughter. A time for mourning, a time for dancing. A time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up. A time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing. A time from searching, a time for losing. A time for keeping, a time for throwing away. A time for tearing, a time for sowing. A time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating. A time for war, a time for peace. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. The reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory be to you, Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going out to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
As we come today to remember Paddy, thank God for his life, and to ask God to comfort us, his family and friends and neighbours. Just begin with a little reflection about, I suppose, the story of life, the story of all of our lives. The life of each of us can be thought of as a series of stories that come together over time to form one story, a story that is profoundly ours and absolutely unique. The story in question is the story of our life, and everybody's story deserves to be known and respected. When we know a person's story, we see the person in a friendlier light. If we took the time to get to know each other's stories, we would understand each other better, and as a result, might be kinder to each other. When a person dies, their life story passes before us. It's all laid out before us, its successes and failures, joyful and sorrowful mysteries. It is like a book suddenly thrown open for all to read. However, there are no facts about a person that tell the full story of their life. What we have are fragments. Even the pattern of the life can escape us. We believe that the full story of our life is known only to God. As our psalm reminded us today, the word of God deep within our being. God sees our heart. We see the surface. The sad fact is that all our stories end in death, and even when the death comes naturally at the end of a long and a full life, we do not like a story that ends like that. We want our stories to end happily. And this is where we believe the resurrection of Jesus comes in. Jesus lived his life, died, but conquered death. Not by avoiding it, by passing through it and overcoming it. And we believe that through our baptism, he gives us power to do the same. What happened to Jesus happens to us too. When Jesus came on earth, he came clothed in our humanity. And in this humanity, he lived, suffered, and died. And this humanity, and in that, he rose from the dead. If it happened to the human flesh of Jesus, we believe it happens to us too. If his humanity can be glorified, so can ours. By rising from the dead, he clothed our mortal humanity with immortality. The resurrection of Jesus opens all our life stories to the prospect not just of a good ending, but of a glorious ending. He has made it possible for us to enter the dark kingdom of death, our hearts full of hope. So we think of Paddy today, born on the 8th of September 1943, so just short of his 77th birthday. He was born in Ballarat in Drumconrath, went to school there, and then he worked in the textile factory in RD. In the 70s he worked for a while in the mill in Slane. From around 1980, he worked in Callan's in Drumconrath, where many knew him as friendly and obliging. You know, someone who said, She went to get her car washed on a Christmas Eve, and Paddy did it obligingly with no word of, or no look or anything like that. A decent gentleman, as people would say. Married Teresa in 1967, and they lived 53 years of marriage. They lived in Drumconra at first, where Paddy was chairman of the GA for 10 years, and moved to Polecastle in 1986. He was a quiet, private man, happy in his own space. He worked long hours in the garden, was the only one to get the hedges and lawns right. He liked to help out Ben, his brother, in farming, and loved the outdoor life. He always provided well for his children, and his grandchildren gave him a great new lease of life in recent years. He loved them and had a special relationship with them, and they loved him in return. For the last year and a half or so, Paddy's been a bit breathless, but was patient when he wasn't able to do all he used to. He was grateful to his family and friends for their care and support over this last while, and was grateful to have had such good help for so long. So we think of Paddy, these in other terms. We all have our own many stories of Paddy, his life, his service to our community. Particularly think of people in time of difficulty. The readings today talked about that whole gamut of life from birth to death. The planting and the sowing, as it is about, doesn't mention clipping, but I'm sure you could add it in there as well. But that birth, death cycle of life, I suppose ultimately Paddy and all of us enter that cycle, and we believe that even in death there is hope of resurrection and new life, just as spring follows winter. The psalm Samantha sang for us, lovely, just reminds us of that depth in our life. And maybe particularly over these last number of months, we have maybe discovered new depths. We've been thrown back on our own resources when we couldn't go anywhere. Maybe Paddy being content in his own garden, in his own space, was somebody we could learn from that. But we're thrown in on ourselves, and particularly the time of loss, the depths of our own life. Hopefully we find God there and the love that we share with others. And love then, love of family, being a child of God, as the second reading reminds us, that all of us are united in that way, and we express that today as we gather around Paddy's coffin, but also the broader community. Even these times of social distancing and all that, we still gather around to support and help each other in loss. The place for all of us in God's kingdom is, we're reminded of that in the gospel. There are many rooms in God's house. We think of Paddy providing his home for his family with Teresa and all of those things that have made that up over the years. But also we believe that he has gone to God, that as we say goodbye to him today, his relatives, those who've gone before him, welcome him into God's kingdom, and maybe give us a little peace to know that Paddy is safe with God and safe with them. We ask God to comfort us, help us to comfort each other, to be gentle with each other, to be gentle with ourselves in our time of loss. So now maybe we'll have our prayers of the faithful, please. We bring our prayers before the Lord, confident he listens to them, because with them there is love, mercy, and compassion.
Today we are saddened by the loss of Paddy, whom we have loved. May our hope in the resurrection and the promise of eternal life bring us comfort and turn our sadness to joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the family and friends of Paddy, especially his wife Teresa, sons Patrick, David and Dermot, and daughter Caroline, grandchildren, sisters and brother. In these difficult days, may the Lord be their strength and their consolation. Lord, hear us. We pray for all our deceased relatives and friends, especially Paddy's parents, Terence and Kathleen, his sister Maggie. May the Lord bring them into the light of his presence and give them a share in his glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the nurses and doctors of Boyne Suite West, Our Ladies of Lourdes Hospital, Drogheda, for their kindness, dedication and care for Paddy. May they experience the loving kindness of the Lord in these difficult times. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Just for a moment, we gather our own prayer, our own thought of Paddy and ourselves in our loss. Think of over the last number of months, think of those who have died, and it was the difficulty of bereaving and grieving in a time of social distance, and all of those, we offer all of that to God. But also we remember the happy times. It was like football, the happy days, but also the days when we didn't win either, and we mix all of that up into the mix of our lives. Pray for deceased members of Paddy's family. Lord, hear us. God of love and mercy, give us the assurance that beyond death there is a life, where broken things are mended, lost things are found, where there is rest for the weary, joy for the sad, where all that we have loved and willed of good exists, and where one day we will meet again our loved ones. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
I'm not afraid.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look favourably on our offerings, O Lord, so that Paddy may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of a blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and saints and the hosts of heaven, we join the hymn of your glory as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Thomas, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Paddy, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Remember also his sister Margaret. God, they were united with Christ, united with your Son in a death like his. May now be one with him in resurrection. Remember, brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep, know of resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles, the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. So now we pray in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, say our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We pray that Paddy, we believe, is in God's eternal rest and peace. We ask that some of that peace would come to us in our loss, that it would come to the world at these challenging times as well. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Sorry, I sent Timothy off looking for a prayer for spiritual communion, but doesn't seem to be around. No, it's okay, it's okay. No, it's okay. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So we won't have communion today, but there is a prayer for just spiritual communion to unite ourselves, especially with Jesus at this time, especially this time in our own lives where we are brokenhearted and sad. Jesus, I believe you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I believe that you are already in my heart, and I embrace you there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
How sweet the sound that saved.
We don't like to see a fine day coming to an end. Sometimes, however, as the sun goes down, it sets the heavens on fire and leaves behind an afterglow so beautiful that it stops us in our tracks and causes us to stand and stare in wonder. This lingering afterglow lessens the pain of the sun's departure, eases our passage into the night, and is a sign of a new and glorious dawn. So it is when a good person dies. Even in leaving us, the good confer gifts upon us. After the sun has set on their life, the glow of their goodness lingers on with us. This afterglow eases our passage into the night of grief and acts as a lamp that lights our way through the dark as we wait for the dawn to come and the morning star of hope to rise in our hearts. Through the good we experience the goodness of God, and in them we see the seeds of our own possibilities. We are not meant merely to admire them, but to start afresh because of them. They challenge us to a truer and braver way of living. And that is their final gift to us. So let us pray. God of love, look kindly on Paddy, who has set down the burden of his years. As he served you and others faithfully throughout his life, may you give him the fullness of your peace and joy. We thank God for Paddy's life, caught up in your eternal love. We make this and all our prayers in the name of Jesus, our risen Lord, forever and ever. So thank you today for all who have come and helped, and for abiding by the guidelines at this time, difficult as it may be, in our expressing our sympathy and supporting each other. And thanks to all of them, that through online and all the other ways. Thanks to Samantha for the lovely music we had, and Father Timothy for helping, and Father Connaughton for coming from Drumconrath. In a few moments, we'll have our final prayers for Paddy. We bless his coffin again with the holy water, and we use the incense. And after that, then we bring Paddy to the graveyard. Just as part of the guidelines, if whoever's going with the coffin, a smaller number might go out the door, you come in. If everyone else goes out that middle door, please, and then join us outside. Just some kind of a one-way system, if that's possible. And thank you for abiding. I'm sorry, it's tough. It's enough going on, but thank you for the way you've abided by that in the all the different in the last number of days. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless and protect us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of Paddy. May our farewell express our love for him. May it help ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we will joyfully greet Paddy again, and the love of Christ, who conquers all things, will destroy even death itself. So now Father Timothy will sprinkle the coffin with the holy water, a reminder of the baptism, that is Paddy's promise of eternal life, and the incense also of his dignity as a person, and our prayers going with him to God. Our response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul, present him to God the Most High. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul, present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul, present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Paddy, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you gave to Paddy in life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward each of us today and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Paddy. Help us who remain to comfort each other with our faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and Paddy forever. So in peace now we take Paddy to his place of rest in our graveyard.
When I had a nightmare, recording.